Welcome back, everyone. This is the Husqvarna review for the walk behind lawn mower. This is a all-wheel drive mower. So this is an unboxing. All right, how you doing? This is Carlo with the Husqvarna walkthrough. This is a Lowe's bought lawn mower that I got from Lowe's. The first one I had was from Tractor Supply Store. Tractor Company Store. I can't remember. TCS. Something like that. Anyway, really great place. They have Cub Cadet, Husqvarna, and they have some other stuff there as well, too. A lot of these stores are all carrying Husqvarna products now. Primarily because they're like getting into the stores, how craftsmen were into the stores and things like that. So they're bringing an everyday homeowner's use product to the market, which they've always had. Just in the last few years, it's really took off and people are starting to recognize the brand name. Some people don't like it, some people like it, some people say it's just okay. I have to say it's kind of all those things. You know, it depends what you get. Commercial version versus the homeowner version. Now, their mowers have come a long way. A lot of their stuff was basically throughout the MTD things you buy, Cub Cadet as well, and Craftsman. They were pretty much toy built. They're all the same, basically. And you have your Toro, your John Deere, your Snapper, and boys can go on and on the list. And you got your your X-Mark. Those aren't things that you're going to buy every day in every store, you know. What you're going to find in most of your stores now is the Husqvarna. Now, this is all going to go electric real soon, so enjoy the gas while you can get it. Now, this is an all-wheel drive mower. This is a 21-inch cut L221. Don't know why they did it like that, because it is confusing. It looks like it says an L22-inch, you know, the way it's like that. L22-1A. Another one that I had a Kohler engine on it, and it was a little underpowered. The engine was fine. I liked it. I used it. I had to return it because it was a store model, just to be fair. It was a store model. It was up on the racks. It's been around for the whole entire year. A lot of people handled it, banged it around, dropped it, who knows, whatever. The handles were a little crooked. I thought I could deal with it, but my OCD took over. I couldn't handle the crooked handles. So that's mainly the reason why I took it back. It had some issues with the wheel locking up, which I'm kind of concerned this one does the same thing. I've heard some remarks about people saying that as well, that the front wheels lock out and it blows grass out of the front. That's a bad design flaw in the product, but I'll go through that. Maybe they fixed it, I don't know. But there's ways you could fix it as well. But the all-wheel drive is remarkable. I thought I could live without it, so I went back to some older motors. I fix and tinker with motors from time to time. But the all-wheel drive is awesome. At first, it drives a little squirrely. You gotta get used to it, so but once you get used to it, you feel the way it rides, it drives. You drive it, you know, and you walk behind it. You can use one hand and stand at any point of it and control this thing. So it'll climb up a hill all by itself on its own. Now, if you have a loaded bag and you're going up a hill, I mean, obviously you got to give a little bit of a push, but basically just a nudge, it goes up. So anyhow, I want to do this as an unboxing, so I'll get one tomorrow. It says not to use knives, but there you go. Cut it on both sides. What you do is lift it up if you want to use the knife. Just run it along the top while you're lifting it. You see that? Don't ever run, there's a reason why it's just not use the bag. If you go like that and push down and you run this across too deep, you will cut the bag. See? The bag is right there, so don't do that. There's a reason why they put warning signs on things. So anyhow, let's put that away. Alright. I've already had one of these, the other one that I did, so the bag. See, I like buying stuff in a box. I hate getting the stuff off the shelf. This one came with its oil. The other one didn't come with oil. So this is in the box. You got to put this together, which is nice. I like putting it together myself. Bag is really well made, except for one part. Right here. Now this one looks like it was made better. Yeah, this one looks a lot better. This one has two stitching. The one I got from Tractor Supply, now same thing. I don't know, maybe it got snagged on something, or I think it was because it was a store model. It's been drug around and who knows who did what to it. But I did notice that this stitching came out and it looked frayed. It did nothing to the effect of it, but just looked frayed. So, this one's pretty good. Yeah, right, like the emblems, looks nice. Of course, it's all gonna get dirty once this time of the year, so, but this bag is a very well-designed bag. It breathes good. This slit is very important. It allows the air to flow through without being blocked. And one thing I've noticed with the other one, this thing throws grass into the bag. It throws it to the top, so it falls in the bottom. I've had some other brands out there, all of them, you know, who knows, Brass Contoro, whatever, a lot of Toros I've had. And the bags usually get, when they get to the top, close to getting full, they get clogged. You gotta take the bag off, push it back in there, put it back down. You do not have to do that with this model. Really great feature. That's one of the reasons why I got another one. Now I'm a medium commercial guy, so I like to have a regular push mower on my truck at all times. I call it a shit mower, excuse my language, it's a crap mower, something I can get in places, but, you know, I kind of wanted a nice one, so I still have a crap mower that I know when I got to go to those jobs, but this one here, I've had to use this when my commercial 30-inch Toro walk-behind mower, it breaks down on me, and, you know, that's the job mower that I use a lot, but I'll go to this one, to the Husqvarna push mower. I'm done buying Toro push mowers, the small ones. Overpriced, they break like anything else does. So let's get the Husqvarna try since I'm buying everything else Husqvarna, you know. So I like it. I didn't think I would like a push mower, you know, but it's a nice mower and it looks real cool. I mean, for a mower to look cool, that's just another added bonus. If you're cutting grass, I mean, you feel better because it looks cool. So anyhow, there's your bag. Just snap these in. Okay, it's pretty simple. Just snap them in as you go. Just snap. Very simple and easy to do. Just snap that out. Of course, you got your slit here for it hooks onto the back. Yeah. That's interesting. Little scratches on there. I don't know why they are. They're from the box. Lip over there. The last one goes on. Good. You got your bag is done. It's all in. You got your oil in there, which is nice. There you go. Bag is up the pin. AWD. Alright. Taking the lawnmower out. Usually they want you to cut the box to get the lawnmower out. I want to do that. I might want to use the box for storage. Put things in it. No instructions on how to take the lawnmower out without breaking it. Okay. To remove mower from cartoon. From the cartoon. To remove mower from the cartoon. Open top of the cartoon, the carton. Remove loose parts, including with the mower. I.e. grass catcher frame, hardware pack. Locate and remove the owner's manual. Okay, cut down the corners on one edge of the carton and lie end down flat. Remove any other packing materials. Roll mower out of carton and see owner's manual. For setup instructions, please check carton thoroughly for loose parts. Of course, I'm not going to do it that way. But everybody else should. Only because I want to use this box to put other crap in my garage in it. So, yep, owner's manual. Yep. There is a bunch of. I can see this. Let's go. There you go. There it is. Piece of cardboard.
take that off. These are your handlebars. That's interesting. It is missing a knob on the handlebar.